Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there. The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Any good?
Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and
pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Thank you. question deadline!
Damn.
You can't stop me!
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Inside now! Oh no! Stop! No! God damn it, die! No! No! No!
Trapped. There was no way out.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there. You must go into the light. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. This way, there's no time. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Pick up the flashlight. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
This is it, wait! Just like me. I can keep this up forever! I can keep this up forever!
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying it. I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller! How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car. We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love.
So much for quiet vacation.
Because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Do me a favor, Sonny! I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good, solid whack! You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up! Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey to get the key
you?
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake. Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
She should change the bulb.
Thanks,
this
Rose.
Is what happens when you...
We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. and to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Pat Maine here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset. Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public. An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Alice? Honey?
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it?
He's
my favorite writer.
Well, Rose,
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Maine on KBFFM. And now, some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice! You! Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Damn it. Alice? The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
Alan! Help me! Alan! No! No!
Alice? Alice? Oh, no!
Keep going, Alan. Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident. Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Listen,
deposit. I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased to meet you.
Premium
cabin. Incontestably
proven health
benefits.
see the sights!
Keep those cholesterol levels down.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
During your
stay, I recommend
trying.
Yes.
It's the latest.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. How may I?
Hello? Hello?
Proven health benefit. Let you.
Stone.
The spirit.
Silence and keep those cholesterol levels. During your
stay, I recommend
trying. It's the latest.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Proven.
Hello. Hello.
Let you
kill
with one stone.
The spirit.
Those cholesterol.
There were more of them. My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station. What was that? When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
And I want something special to eat.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Hazardous occupation!
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Thank you.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather's absolutely...
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best
dogs in the state.
Belly Burster is the best with no
cuts. Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.